Hi there, welcome back to the Grape Explorer. I hope you are all keeping safe and well. This week, the WSET, the Wine and Spirit Education Trust, announced that some of their courses are going 100% online, including, for the first time, the examination component of the course. This is, of course, absolutely fantastic news, and so there's really no better time to begin a wine education or to further your education if you started that journey. So today, what I thought I'd do is take you through the current courses that are available with the WSET, not just the wine courses, the other courses as well, to see what's on offer. If you're new to this channel, welcome. I'm the Grape Explorer. I bring you wine education, product reviews, and lots of wine tasting. So if you're interested in wine, consider subscribing. So let's get started off with those wine courses specifically, starting off with the Level 1 Award in Wine. Now, this particular course is a beginner level introduction to wine, and it's ideal for those who are either perhaps hobbyists, enthusiasts, or someone who may be starting a career in wine. The Level 1 course typically takes place over the course of just one day, and as part of that course, you will explore the main types and styles of wine. You'll be addressing and assessing wines through the sight, smell, and taste using a systematic approach to wine tasting. You'll be learning the basic skills required to describe those wines, as well as looking at things like food and wine pairing, what works, what doesn't work, and why, and the service and storage of wines. I personally started off at level one. I wanted to start right at the beginning, and it is actually a really great insight into the very basics around wine. Even if you've got a little bit of knowledge, it is maybe something you might be worth getting on board with, just to get comfortable with the whole exam scenario and being back in a school and learning environment. If you've moved on from level one, you will of course move to level two. Now, before we look at the course details for level two, I should just say that you do not have to have taken level one to then take level two. You can jump straight into level two. So let's take a look at that course in a little bit more detail. The WSET would consider level two awarding wines to be a beginner to intermediate level qualification. Again, it's suitable for people who are simply enthusiastic about wine, but it's definitely something that would be recommended for someone working in the industry. You start to look at the principal and regionally important grape varieties around the world. You start to look at the different styles of wine that are produced, as well as things like the factors that impact style and quality, both in the vineyard and in the winery. And then you also start to describe wines with confidence. And by that I mean you start to use a much more detailed, systematic approach to tasting than you would have done at level one. You're really starting to talk about things like acidity, body, tannin, length, as well as digging a lot deeper into the aroma characteristics and flavor characteristics of a wine. Level two is typically taught over a 3-day period, or perhaps one day over 3 weeks. That was certainly how I did mine, with a multiple choice exam at the end. Now, like I say, I started at level one, but you can absolutely jump into level two. Lots of what I covered off at level two was really a refresher of level one before we got into more of the detail. For those of you who've already done level two, I'm sure you're now thinking about level three. So let's take a look at level three award in wine. This would definitely be considered a more advanced level qualification, a lot more private study time required for this one, and this is really aimed at professionals working in the wine industry or for serious wine enthusiasts, someone like myself. What I did as part of this course was to delve a lot deeper into the world of wine. It was really starting to gain a deeper understanding of viticulture and all the various components that go into that. You know, climate, site selection, the soils, the vineyard cycle, all of the different processes that can take part in the winery. So you do get a detailed understanding of grape growing and winemaking. You are assessing wines more accurately using an even more descriptive systematic approach to tasting, which gives you the ability to confidently explain wine style and quality. Now, as part of this course, the exams also get a lot tougher. In addition to the multiple choice, you're also going to have a short answer question, as well as a blind tasting exam, where you are expected to go into detail about the characteristics of that wine. Just two wines, you have 30 minutes to do it, but it is quite a tense environment to put yourself in. Now, if you've successfully passed level three and you think you can take your knowledge a little bit further, The next level up is the Diploma in Wines, or Level 4, and the WSET recommends this especially as an expert level qualification covering all aspects of wine. And there is a serious amount of commitment required on your part. So in the main, this is really aimed at those working in the wine industry, although of course there are a number of people who continue their hobby into this particular course. The diploma goes on to deepen your understanding of wine production, as well as the business and economic factors that would influence the style, quality, and price of wines. There is a comprehensive study of a large number of wine regions with some really deep theoretical development, as well as practical development, developing your wine tasting skills to an expert level. The course itself recommends over 370 hours of private study, and this is why I say it's a considerable commitment from you as an individual, and which is why in the main it's suited to people in the wine industry who are able to be living and breathing wine day to day. But of course that doesn't mean to say that hobbyists do not take the diploma, and I know a number of people who are taking this route. The course itself comprises of six modules, and there is an exam per module. So it is a very in-depth course that takes place over, I believe, a couple of years. There is also a large cost associated with taking the course. You know, wine courses aren't cheap, and the diploma over that significant period of time, it does mean that it is a serious investment to you as an individual. So, with all of the wine courses covered, let's take a look at the other courses that the Wine and Spirit Education Trust cover. The clue's in the title there, they don't just cover wine, they look at spirits as well. So let's take a look at Level 1 in Spirits. This is a beginner introduction course for those who are starting a career perhaps in the industry, or anyone who is interested in the consuming and the education of spirits. It's very much a hands-on introduction to the world of spirits. It gives you an exploration of the main styles and types, as well as developing an understanding of key factors that would influence flavour and aromas. So very much like Level 1 in Wine, this is a basic introduction to the course. You will cover the main spirits really. You'll be looking at things like gin, rum, whiskey, vodka for example. But again, it's designed to be that simple introduction to get you started on an educational path with spirits. As with wines, the further you go in your education process, the more in-depth and developmental for yourself as an individual the courses become. And that's very much reflected in the spirits at Level 2, which again is considered a beginner to intermediate level qualification, really for those who are, again, hobbyists or enthusiasts. But you're going to start to learn a lot more about the production methods and the raw materials that go into creating those spirits, as well as discovering how they're used to make the key spirit styles and exploring the key practices and principles of serving spirits and the use of spirits in cocktails. So again, you're getting that broader understanding at Level 2 that you wouldn't have got at Level 1. You're going to be tested on an exam at the end of the course, but you're going to be coming away with a much deeper insight into spirits. And that then continues into their Level 3 course in spirits as well, which, as like Level 3 in wines, is an advanced level qualification really aimed at professionals or someone who is a real enthusiast into the world of spirits. You get a bit more of a theoretical understanding of the techniques used, as well as the processing of raw materials to post-distillation operations. And you need to explain why spirits look and taste the way that they do and why they differ from each other. And again, that means practice in school and lots of study time outside of the school, outside of the classroom as well. So those are three spirit courses that are also available. And the final courses I'm going to go through are for sake. Now, interestingly, when it comes to sake, the information that I was able to gather from the Wine and Spirit Education Trust website was that they offer a Level 1 and a Level 3. So I'm not actually sure what's happened to Level 2. It may be that Level 3 is because it's a much more in-depth course. It's sort of on the same par as taking Level 3 in Wines and Spirits. But let's take a look at Level 1 first. So this is a beginner level introduction to sake for those starting a career in the industry or just pursuing an interest in sake. And again, as with the other Level 1 courses, it's just a basic introduction to the world, the main styles and different types, and it helps you develop an understanding of key factors that would affect flavors and aromas. And then when we come on to Level 3, it's that more advanced level qualification for professionals as well as serious enthusiasts. So again, taking you through the production methods that affect the style, quality and price, and it's helping you to assess sakes accurately and using that information and your understanding to make authoritative recommendations. So again, What you do on the wines course, as you do with the spirits and the sake, is you're able to recommend certain types of wine, spirits, sakes, against perhaps food pairing or recommendations to someone. If they were in a restaurant, they were asking for a sake, what would you recommend? There is a real service component to some of these exams. So you do need to be able to put yourself in the scenario where someone is asking you for a recommendation. And that goes across all the different courses. I hope this has been an interesting insight into what's available from the WSET. If it were me taking a course, the one that really jumps out for me is actually sake. I'm a huge fan of sushi. It would be great to pair that with some great sake. So the level one course, which I know is now available online 100%, including the examination, is something that I'm going to be looking into. And if I do look into it, of course, I will let you know all about it. But over to you. Where are you at in your wine education? Are there particular courses that you were planning to take that you can now take now that they're online? Are you at the start of your wine journey? Are you working through it? Let me know in the comments section below. It'd be lovely to hear from you. Thank you very much for watching today's video. I look forward to seeing you all again soon. Cheers.